One of you asked me if I could do a tutorial similar to the one I prepared for the students, but this time for the lecturer who should prepare his course on Moodle. So this is a tutorial for you lecturers who wish to prepare your course in the learning management system. So first of all, you have to go to the website combonihartum.com. There you can download the Android application so that you can also work from your mobile phone if you wish. Of course, it is more comfortable to work from the computer when possible. Then you can get access to the learning platform either through this icon, Combo Moodle, or through this one, e-learning. Both take you to the home page of the learning management system. Here you will have to log in and write the password and username that you were given. Once here, you try to find your course. You can search them either through this one, or by typing the name of the course. Imagine you are a lecturer of the Bachelor in English Language and Literature, and you are the lecturer of Spanish language, for instance. Here you see the let us see one that here the lecturer of Spanish has already prepared his content. So let us see another one that is empty. For example, let us take another one of another lecture of English language. For example, we take poetry. And there you find this structure, just the unit for every week. Of course, these dates are not the real ones, it's just an example on which you can work. To work, the first thing you have to do is to turn editing on. This is the first step, to turn editing on. You see that the interface changes, and now you can change the period, or you can put here the name of the title of the unit. You see here, if you click here, you can have the section name, and then here you can write, for example, if you want learning objectives of this lesson, contents, references, and then you will save these contents. And then you can add activities or resources. So you see there are two kinds of addition items you can add. One, as I said, it is called activities, and the other one, resources. Resources, for example, you can upload a PDF file you have prepared, a PowerPoint presentation, or a link to a website, etc., etc. And these are different kinds of activities you can ask from the students. Now let us see. Let us go to my course, the one I prepared, so that I can show you a concrete example. In my case, I have this in the Bachelor of Educational and Religious Studies. My subject is At-Tahdid wal-Idara at-Tarbawiyya. So here I have put the title of the subject and the kind of introduction. This you can do like this. I show you. I prepare this kind of banner with PowerPoint, and then here you can paste this image or upload this image, and then I copy and paste from my Word file the introduction to the subject. Then you can save changes whenever you wish. Then in my case, I added this questionnaire that I prepared with Google Docs, but this is more complicated. Yes, I want to know how many of the students they have their own laptop or they have access to the internet either through the smartphone or even through the laptop, not to know up to which point how the percentage of students in my class that have access to the internet. This I did with Google questionnaires. This you can put some news. So now this is the first unit. You remember that in the previous case you could see like something from April. Now in my case, since I teach on Saturday, so the first Saturday is supposed to be the 6th of June. And this is the presentation of the unit with the objectives, the contents, and some sources. As I said before, I did it by writing here the date of my lesson. Then I took this that I have prepared with a PowerPoint, and this the title. And then something which is important to give a more professional presentation is, for example, this case, this kind of titles, I put them in my case heading medium, always the same kind of character to give a kind of coherence to the presentation. And this the content is has this kind of character paragraph. Certainly you can change the size and the, but it's always good to have this kind of uniformity that gives a kind of professional appearance to the student. So then in addition to the presentation of the unit, I have, as I said before, two kind of items. One are resources and the other one activities. This resource is a PDF file I have prepared from with the contents I want the students to study. This is just a question of uploading the file that you can drag here or take from your computer. This maybe I will show you also how to add a PDF file, but it's quite easy. So for example, imagine you want to add a PDF file. You go to File, you add, then you can have the name of the PDF file, a description of the file, then you can choose if you want to have that description visible for the students, and then here you take the PDF file from your computer or you drag it here. And then you save and it will appear among the items of that first unit. Of course this will come down, but you can move, no? It is very easy to move according to your organization. Then this title I put here, I do it through label. I will show you how to put this kind of word here that helps to distinguish between the resources of the lesson and the activities. No, it is always here. You have here this label. Add label. Here is the in this case I wrote Al-Masadir. But even here you can put a photo, or if you want to put a line, no, to this, or you can even embed a video. That this is up to you. Then also you can choose if it is visible or not. This is interesting because, for example, in my case, I have prepared the lessons for the whole semester. But maybe I want the students to see just the coming one. I don't want them to see everything. This is up to you. So you can choose if you want to have things visible or not for the student. No? For example, now if I wrote this like this, no, then it's also good for you to know that here you can write from, because in my case I'm writing Arabic, you will be writing in English, so it will be easier for you. But they have also these editing possibilities. Now, if I put this, you will see at the end of this lesson one, this anyway, this I put it in any way, but now I can duplicate it. Imagine, for example, when I prepare this kind of division between resources and activities, I duplicate it so that I put the same shape in every unit. So among the activities, this you will have to explore. But this is, for example, this is a quiz. A quiz with different questions that help the student to do a revision of the lesson. You can put multi-choice questions or essay, like they have to write a little test, and you can choose if you want to give them 5 lines, 10 lines, how long you want them to write. So you see, I have always the same structure. Even this is unit 2. This I prepare, as I said, with PowerPoint, and then you have always the same kind of character. In this case, I have 3 activities and then the PDF file. Here I put a link with a book from Google Books that is a kind of important resource for this lesson. Even sometimes you have open source books that may help the student to go further, and then you can also upload this in addition to the PowerPoint or the PDF file you have prepared. So you see, this is the appearance when you are editing. If you want to see how the students see what you have prepared, you turn editing off here. Now it takes a lot of time because you know our Sudanese internet is always slow. And now this is the way students see what you have prepared. With Arabic, it's always a bit difficult with Moodle to have this well ordered, but with English works much better and much easier. But as you see, always I have this structure, a kind of presentation of the unit with the aims, the contents and the resources, and then some resources and activities for the student. So this is the way it appears to the student. In this case, I have prepared lessons until 29th of August, but as I said before, I can choose by selecting again. Now I can turn the editing on to see if I want the students. I can hide the topic so that the students will not see until I wish. And this is all. Good luck.